Two of the top leaders at Penn State failed to protect children from Jerry Sandusky for more than a decade. The report into how the university handled allegations of sex abuse for years were just released.
And it is nothing short of scathing. Tonight, we break it down. The four men blamed in the report, while Joe Paterno's son comes out swinging to protect his father's legacy, to the possible civil lawsuits to be filed.
We have live team coverage of every angle of this developing story tonight, live from Center County for you. Channel 4 Action News anchor Andrew Stocky is there. Andrew?
Well, Wendy, tonight Penn State is reeling from the explosive details in that 267-page report issued by Louis Freeh's committee, now citing a, quote, callous and shocking disregard for the child victims of Jerry Sandusky. And that disregard apparently goes up to the highest levels of Penn State University. That includes former head football coach Joe Paterno.
From Philadelphia to State College to Pittsburgh, the task force findings were shocking and damning.
Our most saddening and sobering finding is the total disregard for the safety and welfare of Sandusky's child victims by the most senior leaders at Penn State. The most powerful men at Penn State failed to take any steps for 14 years to protect the children who Sandusky victimized.
The findings in the Freeh report placed blame on four men, four leaders who, quote, failed to protect against a child sexual predator harming children for over a decade.
Mr. Spanier, Schultz, Paterno, and Curley never demonstrated, through actions or words, any concern for the safety and well-being of Sandusky's victims until after Sandusky's arrest.
The Board of Trustees, though not implicated, were found to have created an environment which allowed this to happen. Their reaction to the report?
Let me be absolutely clear. An event like this can never happen again in the Penn State University community. Judge Freeh's report is both sad and sobering.
Most stunning, the report's findings that Joe Paterno knew of Sandusky's crimes before the 2001 shower incident. He knew of a 1998 investigation, but did nothing.
It is more reasonable to conclude that in order to avoid the consequences of bad publicity, the most powerful leaders at Penn State University, Mr. Spanier, Schultz, Paterno, and Curley, repeatedly concealed facts relating to Sandusky's child abuse from the authorities, the Board of Trustees, the Penn State community, and the public at large.